have you ever heard someone say, another developer say, don't worry, the caching will sort that out, or don't worry that this code is really inefficient, we'll sort that out when we cache it all, and stuff like that. Well, if you've heard any of those kind of things, if you said it yourself, then perhaps that's an indicator that you really need to address the core problem. Hello and welcome to another How to Code Well web chat. Today we're going to talk about caching. Caching isn't the silver bullet. I'm sorry to say, caching isn't the silver bullet when it comes to speed and performance. If the system is slow to begin with, then that is an indicator that you need to refactor the code, look at all the triggers that make the code inefficient. Yes, caching will solve a lot of problems, but caching itself can cause problems down the road. You get what's called stale caching, where the cache itself becomes out of sync from the real data. Now, caching, like I said, isn't the plaster. It's not the golden grail. It's not the silver bullet that's going to solve all of your speed issues. So one piece of advice that I would give every web developer is, when developing your application in your local environment, is to try and develop that without caching turned on. And when I say caching turned on, there's lots of mechanisms for caching. So for example, memcache, make sure that that's off. Things like optimizing your autoloader, that can become troublesome, especially when you're developing, you're still working on the application. And query caching and stuff like that. Once you're working on code in its raw form, so it's not going through any filters or clean scripts or any kind of thing to store that information for later requests, you can get a raw output, if you will, of how your code is actually functioning and performing, the raw benchmark, if you will. And then analyze the code and go, well, you know, this request is taking, say, I don't know, 5 seconds, this request is taking 2 seconds. And then look at all the little parts of that code, the functions and so forth that code goes through to make those calls to build up that response. The second piece of advice I would like to give is to use some profiling tools. So there's a lot of PHP-based profiling tools out there that you can use to profile the code, to work out how much memory it's consuming and so forth. There is a component that you can use called stopwatch, which is part of the Symfony package, but you can use that as well in other applications. So for example, if you were to write a command script to go through a lot of logical steps, you can time those steps and you can time those against the events and so forth and output that. It's very handy, like I said, when you're writing command scripts that do a lot of operations, and you can time box those operations. You can say, well, how long did that piece take? The golden rule really is that you need to have some good metrics as to how your application is performing. And you want to try and do that in development, right? You also want to do that, of course, in production, but you want to try and get those pain points, those pinch points, before it goes into production. You want to know where your code is the slowest. And so you can plan for that and you can put things around it. If you were to just throw memcache on, put it in production and go, well, I'm done, then yes, it will be relatively quick, one would imagine, but still, when it comes to adding things to that application, improving the features and so forth, you'll be putting those kind of things, those new requirements, on a system that is just so sluggish. And it really needs to be like streamlined super quick. There is a saying that I use quite frequently, and that is a death by a thousand cuts. So for example, you might be using a sample size of say 10, maybe 50 records when you're running a script. And that's the same for other reference data. For instance, you could have a table of statuses that don't frequently change. Maybe it's 5 or 6 types of statuses that the user can have, and you're doing a select query on that for every time the user does something to get the new status, the next status. That can be put in cache as well. Just remember that when things are in cache, that if there is a change to that information, then that cache needs to be updated, flushed and removed and replaced and so forth. There are tools and mechanisms that can help with that. Another thing is the opcache. So if you're if you've got a lot of stuff, like for example your composer or autoloader, you want to put that in caching as well. And opcache does that very, very well. You want to configure your application to not do that in development, because that can trip you up. It tripped me up quite recently. I changed a file name, a class name of a PHP class, and then I ran the application and it tripped up because the cache had the old version of that class, that that link to that class in the cache. And I was trying to request a new version and it just tripped up. So you want to make sure that when you do your deployments, you want to clear that cache out and so forth. What I've just said there is a representation of stale cache, where something in the cache is outdated, not synchronized with the actual physical thing. It's the same with insert records. So if you're doing an insert into a database, you want to make sure that that cache is then altered, so when you do a select query, you're not just selecting the old stuff. That can cause a lot of problems, a lot of problems. You don't want your caching to be an issue. You don't want to be solving problems, bugs, because of caching. You want to make sure that the caching gets rebuilt or flushed whenever you do a deployment and so forth. And it's when the cache gets rebuilt, that's when things start slowing down, because obviously the cache needs to build up and so forth. And you are essentially using the old system without cache for a little bit, right? So there's gonna be users that are working on stuff that's quite slow, seeing things that are quite slow, and then there'll be users who come after them will be seeing things quite fast. Now, obviously, you want to make sure your application is as quick and as speedy and as streamlined as possible, and this is where you start looking at the inefficiencies of your code, or at least look at those before you even consider putting it in cache. A thing that really trips a lot of people up is inefficient loops. So that's when you're looping through a lot of data. And again, I go back to the example of your sample size. You might be developing on a sample size of say 10 or 50, but when it actually comes into production in real life, that loop could be dealing with thousands, hundreds of thousands of stuff. And so the small little inefficient thing that you've just witnessed is then going to be amplified when that loop gets used a lot. So make sure that you really streamline your loops. So doing a lot of queries within a loop should be flagged up, right? So if you're, again, if you're using reference data, then get that kind of data outside of the loop first and then put it in. Other things that can really help is using transactions. So when you're doing a lot of insert queries, maybe if it's something that is scheduled up, then put them in transactions and then commit that, and then flush from, if you're using Doctrine, then do a clear and a flush on a batch, right? So don't do that one after the other. If you really need to think of, you know, when am I actually going to use this information again, if you're persisting the data all the time. So you really need to think about how the application is used in the sense of the user behavior, but also how much the system is going to be used, how much of that loop is going to be executed. You might be working, like I said, on 10, 15 things now, but that could be completely different. And so the death by a thousand cuts comes into play when suddenly the requests just spike and your little inefficient thing is now, you know, 10 times as bad as it is because of that. And yes, caching will sort of paper the cracks, but seriously, you want to be using caching in a very pragmatic way, right? You want to be using caching in a way that solves problems that aren't solving the inefficiencies of your bad code. If it's bad code, then fix the bad code, okay? I'm not saying that I'm perfect at this, because there's a lot of things that I've done where I review and go, hang on a minute, that is slowing it down. One thing I try and do is, like I said, turn off the caching and work in a development environment. I mean, one thing I do quite a lot with the Symfony stuff is work in the app dev environment when I'm in development. obviously you have lots of benefits there because you have your the web tool toolbar thing at the bottom that can show you some statistics and analytics on the system. And yes, you need to compensate the time that toolbar gets generated and so forth. And also in development, it spits out a load of logs that you don't need, or you won't need in production at least. So yes, it does, just by using development will slow the thing down, but at least you have a foundation to work off of, right? At least you're not just saying, yeah, caching will just deal with that. Another thing is the database, right? So if the database in it is designed in a poor way, then that's going to slow a lot of stuff down. So you've got your caching, you've got your code, and you've got your database. Really, what you should be looking at is the database, looking how the data is structured. Is there a way I can explain the queries, find the slow queries using a slow query log, for example, to identify areas of the database that I can tweak and speed up? You want to be looking there really first, and then looking at the code, and then looking at the memcache. Maybe there is some stuff that you can tweak in the database to make that quicker, and there is certain memory allocation and threads and all that configuration that you can do, especially for MySQL. You might not be using MySQL, but still, whatever you're using, there'll be ways of tweaking the database server to make things a little bit more efficient.